Hi guys, hello, welcome back, welcome back.
Welcome
I'm the one singing back. Today.
Hello, Joanna.
Welcome back.
Welcome back.
Okay, guys, welcome to another episode of the Real Talk with
the Salami.
I'm Jumoke Salami and
I'm Rotsi May Salami.
And we are
the Salami.
All right, guys, it's good to have you guys back once again. And babes, So I saw online today, like this morning, like the lady discovered that after 2 years in marriage, She discovered her husband is also attracted to men.
Actually, I read that stuff too, and I don't know. What came into my head was that could it be that the guy had been attracted to men way before marriage, or it just started happening?
I do not feel it's something that just comes up like that. I think things like that must have been nurtured for a very long time. You just don't wake up. But it's actually a very dicey one here, because I was just trying to put myself in our shoes. Like, how would you react to such a thing when you know that
Your guy is attracted to another man?
It's really weird. It's crazy. But yeah, who are we to judge? Yeah. But I don't know how. I think this thing goes down to childhood, the kind of home, the kind of upbringing, the kind of love that is attached to every child in a family. You know, sometimes you have kids that have female traits.
Yeah.
Do you see them and you cast them out, or you just bring them close and let them know this is how you should do things with love? Because I feel most male child that end up going through that route must have been shown love by these people that they do not get from the house.
This is the thing, yeah, because I feel this is more like homosexuality. Now, when you're talking about homosexualism, yeah, I think it falls on both sides. The gays and lesbians, you know. While I was growing up, I think I was very much acquainted with the lesbians. I hear so much about lesbianism, unlike when I was grown, when I started hearing so much about it. And of course, the truth about it is it took a while before I did admit that, these people are, normal human. I don't want to say normal, but they are humans, you know, because I still find it hard to believe that, okay, it's a normal thing to do. But because I am not God, because I cannot judge, you know, because God knows the reason why he has created everybody in such a way. But then you mentioned something about, you know, upbringing.
Yeah.
Upbringing has a very huge role to play, because this was where I concluded at the end of the day.
While growing up, I was most times, you know, when they see me, I was very petty. Very, you know, everyone just tends to,
you were still petty till I married you, till I married you.
Yeah, you know, so I had lots of people, female adults then, that would tell you, I like you. You know, some actually came. There was a time one actually came to my room back then and was trying to touch me, and I was like, what? You know, I've gone out with friends and someone would just say, come over here, come to my table, I like you. She gave me a card. You know, I was much more younger. Way younger, let me say like 15, 16. You know, they throw things at you, like they want to give you, they give you goodies of life.
This is one thing I can tell of you. The people that I know, in all fairness, that will show you with so much unimaginable love
and affection, attention,
and give you so much attention, you know, genuinely, this set of people. you know. But then I now asked myself, if we give the same kind of love to the, back to these people,
kids.
To the kids, because you know what, whatever a man becomes starts from way back,
yeah.
as a little child. Now, I always believe that maybe in this part of the world, especially Africa, we would have been able to curb it, you know,
if
to curb kids. Yeah,
if
you don't segregate, you know, if we don't segregate, if we don't discriminate. Because I think I've seen a scenario whereby, you know, a young boy that has a female trait, you know, was passing by and acting, or was acting like a lady as usual. And the next thing, the people are like, please leave this place. What's that nonsense? Oh, boy, should be your brains. Look at him acting like a woman. Please, you shush this boy away. You send him away. He comes to you and wants to say something just because of the way he's delivering the thing. You know, I mean, delivering that same message.
Yeah.
You get irritated and you send him away. What have you done? You have pushed this boy away.
Out.
And you pushed the boy out.
Self-confidence is gone.
He's
actually.
Gone. So now, all of a sudden, someone who is actually an ogbologbo, you understand, in the field already, that is quite mature in the field already.
We'll grab the boy. Talk to him.
Show him love.
And he's
attention
gone.
Attention and everything, and he's gone. So tell me, whatever that kind of person tells that child will be what that child would believe. Whatever kind of life that person shows that person to live, you know, that is what that person, that is the confidence that person will grow up with. Now, sorry to say, I'm not backing Bob Risky up, but I think after he came out and he did his whole whatever, there's this other guy too that came up again, and the guy was trying to be like him, you know, and the next day he started backing the boy up, maybe started sending money and all that. Now, let's look at this thing from a very logical way, showing love. I think this brings us down. This brings us to streamline us to the topic for today. How well do we show
love to our kids?
Not just to our kids. How well do we show love to humans?
Not minding the traits they portray.
Not minding the religion. Not minding where they are from. Not minding if they look good or not. What kind of English they speak? Do they speak Queen's English or do they speak gata English? You know. I think there's too much hatred around the world, and that's one of the things that's actually bringing us down.
Yeah, that it's actually, and it has helped to increase the rate of this thing that we're talking about.
Yeah.
Yes.
So imagine I find out that my wife, I mean, is a lesbian. I'm trying to imagine how I'm going to feel. Very terrible. Like, does that mean I am not man enough? Does that mean what has been missing out?
It actually questions your own capability. Like, you feel maybe you were not doing enough, and that person,
mm-hmm.
you know, it's crazy when you see a woman like this, like me, like this.
You know, we're complete
like this.
You understand? Where I make complete like this. You understand? You know? I mean, last, you know, somebody will now be doing like this.
It's actually crazy.
You know, but at the end of the day, these people are humans. Now, everybody's got their story.
Yes.
They have a reason why that particular marriage you're talking about, that the wife found out, you know, that the husband is attracted to other men. There is a backstory to that thing.
Definitely.
And there's every tendency. A friend confided in me one certain time and told me his story on how he was being abused.
As a child,
how,
I was about to say that.
You understand?
It started as an abuse.
There's a story behind this thing, and I'm still looking forward to this. Say someday, I don't know if we get sponsors for it so that we'll be able to do it adequately. We would like to get stories, original stories from these people. Because I feel that by the time we get to know their story, it is going to change a lot about our perception with them.
Yeah, the mindset.
The mindset. You know,
because sometimes people just feel.
You just see this people and you hate them.
Yes. But when you know what a male child. You know, sometimes.
What led them into that?
We actually know how to curb our female child or the female children.
Yeah.
We don't want them to sit like this. But we just feel that he's a boy. Leave him.
Yeah.
But there are so
you don't
many
pay
things.
Attention.
You don't pay attention because he's a boy. There are so many things that could happen. Is actually one of the topics I feel we should address much later on, how we deal with kids and relatives, and how our kids deals
yeah.
with people. You know, you do not just let out your children like that, because nobody is to be trusted. You don't trust any uncle, no aunt, no. You do not just
leave your... when you don't play your part, you want to come out and judge. Yeah. No, we all, that's the major reason why we all cannot judge.
I know we are some people have their career oriented and all of that, but how well do you take care of these kids? Do you just leave them at home in the hand of one uncle or one nanny that does a whole lot to them? It affects them psychologically, and tomorrow they can't just see any reason why they should follow and not the opposite sex.
But you know the funniest thing? I mean, talking about that, yeah. It's just like when you're born into a family of Northerners. At the end of the day, what language would you speak? Hausa. Do you understand? If you do not pay the proper attention to these kids, at the end of the day, whoever shows them so much love and attention,
that's the way they will.
That is their religion.
That's what.
That is how they will grow, and that is what they will believe that it is the best and best way of life for them to live.
Yes.
Now. You know, they are gradually becoming a big community. You know, yes, the world frowns at it, the holy book frowns at it, but like I said earlier, nobody can judge because you do not know their story. Just like prostitutes that you see on the street, you do not know their backstory, so you cannot judge them. But I'm saying, what have you done?
Don't get judged.
What have you done, do you understand, to make the world a better place? Well, how have you been able to help that little boy growing up, or that little girl growing up with the tomboy attitude? You understand? Yeah. How have you been able to help guide our lifestyle, not just so that she will not end up becoming what you think the world has thrown at? You will neglect that. You would not show them love, and at the end of the day, these people will grow to become what the world frowns at, and at the end of the day, you will start condemning them. Who are you? I mean, it's not even in our own case. It's not that this story pops up. It's not something I really love to talk about.
Yeah.
Even yes, I love to hear their stories. I believe that some of them can even still change.
Yes.
Some of them can change.
Yeah. Because change is something. It can happen to anyone.
It's a very sensitive topic. You know that. We wouldn't want to say the wrong thing on the show. But regarding that woman, you know, that found out about, you know, the husband, you know, after two years of marriage, and you know, and that finds out that the husband is now attracted, yeah, is bi, you know, as a matter of fact, what would you advise this woman to
please
do? What do you think, in your own best of knowledge, you know, and whatever judgment we're passing, let's just be human enough. You know, let's be, if they say human or godly, yeah, God created us in his own like, so let's be godly enough, do you understand, to see the trait of
the
love
truth and not curse,
and
please.
Not curse, do you know,
point
but
out your advice and let's get it, please. No harsh words, because we are not perfect. No one is
nobody's perfect.
So I do not know what shitty thing you're doing. You do not know mine. So because we know ours, thank God she's still anonymous, so we don't know her. So just,
you don't even know what could get people into this system. Because one day I was just thinking that, Rotimi, what if somebody just comes down and say, Rotimi, this is 500 million. Let me just do it. Dollars should be behind. Hey, Chineke, I have to really work hard. Dollars, I mean, there should be dollars behind. Okay, so if imagine somebody now came with $500 million and now said, Rotimi, let me do your anus once. So I was now thinking, how will I accept this thing? You know, just to do your anus once. Maybe just once. Hey, Snake, I was just thinking.
No!
See what money can cost, so, you know.
Were you thinking of doing it?
To be candid, we are humans, though. So. I was just thinking in my head.
I'm thinking,
yes. I've not asked that. Let me see the size of your distance first. But jokes aside, man, it's crazy. On the other hand, if you wear my shoes, like, you see $500 million. But the only thing that will get me scared, because I overthink a lot, I'll be like, for anybody to want to give me $500 million, that person want to use me to do juju. So which means I'll not be the one to spend the money. I'm most likely not gonna take it.
Yes,
I don't know. I'm not going.
No, we're not taking it.
We're not taking it. Even if a clergyman sees me and says that there's somebody who's going to bring on money, it's not a very decent, but I should collect it. But we're not taking it.
We're not taking it. Yeah.
Okay. Anyways, the beautiful tie I'm wearing today is made by Bratao.
Okay.
Bratao make this actually. Okay. And so that's his number on the screen. If you leave around Ojo, and sometimes what am I even saying? He could probably do delivery anywhere now. Just send your measurements and all that. Yeah, it's gonna do something very.
And mine was made by at @moingold_creations. So follow up on Instagram, you're going to see her. You don't have to break your account to look good. Mm-hmm. My glam, my makeup was done by @ayodeji_oladipo. So check her out and she's gonna make you look good. You do not have to break your bank to look good, because I do.
Yeah, right. So until next time, my name remains Rotimi Salami.
And I am Jumoke Salami, and we are
the Salami.
Show some love, guys.
Show some love, guys. It's very, very important.
Yeah.
God bless you. I'm all about Abak Pastoni Montana. Show face. I'm all about see the boy. My wife is beautiful like that. You know, she's just beautiful like that. My money they show. Maru.
That's a dentition.
Maru.
Show me your tits. Show it. Just show it.
I'm shy.
You're shy.